Hi, how you doing? I'm Steve Marks. I'm the product trainer for Blackstar Amplification, and today I'm here at sunny Portsmouth at Nevada Music, and we're just going to go through a little bit of a run through of ID amps. You may have already seen a lot of videos and demonstrations, but I'm just going to show you a little bit of a quick guide, maybe a different way of looking at it. So at the moment, let's firstly talk about the innovation on ID amps. It's our first programmable non-valve amp. And the cool thing about it is the TVP section. This section here, the power section, gives you true valve power. That's what it stands for. And it's as loud as its valve equivalent. It gives you six distinct different valve simulations. So you can get things like 6L6, EL34, EL84, KT88, to name but a few. So you can really recreate some classic sounds and also push the envelope a little further to create your own sounds. And that's what Blackstar's all about. It's about removing limitations and creating your own sound. But I'm going to show you a few sounds that I've come up with which might remind you of some classic amps from over the years. At Blackstar, we don't ignore history. So see what you think. First and foremost, I'm going to play the guitar through the ID amp. We're going through a 60 watt. I'm using just a normal standard Les Paul with standard burst bucket pickups, just so you know. I'm going to play it without TVP engaged, so you can hear it without. If you can as well, it's very hard to always tell on a video. So make sure you come to Nevada and visit your dealer just to hear it and try it, because when you try it, you can really feel that power. But we'll see what we can do with the video. But so at the moment, I'm on a clean, warm voicing. My Blackstar patented ISF is over to the USA side, and I've got ready 6L6s to engage, and there's a touch of spring reverb just to give it a little bit of life. But let me play a lick to you. We'll go with a bit of Nile Rodgers, I think. So now with TVP engaged, it should sound a lot fuller. Really nice. I mean, you can tell the difference, hopefully, through the audio on the video, but when you feel it and when you're playing with it, it's like you're with a valve amp, and the prices are great. For something like this 60 watt head, you're looking at $329 UK, and it's just awesome. So I'm going to throw some licks your way to hopefully put you in mind of some classic sounds, if you will. So from there, we've gone for a nice American warm clean. So. If we go to the next voicing along, which is clean bright, it's kind of a more boutique clean, if you will. There's an earlier breakup as you dig in harder. So if we increase the gain a touch, go to 6V6 for our tube simulation on TVP, ISF still in the American side, a little less on the scoop mid and a little less on the bass, and we should have a really nice, classy, biting blues American small valve combo. So. It's kind of cool. Now, interestingly, ID enables you to really get your clean sounds to really bite hard. So if I increase the gain all the way, remember we're on clean bright still, but check it out, it's killer. A windmill in there as well. It sounds great. So from an American boutique clean, let's go over to a UK boutique clean, and I'll go for something like an EL84 and bring the ISF over to the UK side. If we bring the gain back a touch, you can kind of see where we're going with it. very spongy British 60s kind of vibe. Up from there, if we go to crunch, keep the gain roughly where it is. A little less on the scoop mid, a bit more on the treble. British, EL34, and see if you can guess where I'm taking you now. So. Go. You see where I'm going with that? It's kind of cool. It works really well. TVP was on EL34 then. If I go back to maybe something like a KT66, you can look at some class bluesy sounds. So think of players like Clapton, Peter Green, Billy Gibbons. If you're into that kind of vibe, KT66 works really well. It's a very honky kind of sounding valve. So if I play you a nice lead break on EL34, it works quite nice. KT66. Hopefully you can hear that subtleness, but it's a nice kind of bluesy honk to it. So let's go traditional. Let's roll the tone off on the guitar. I don't see many of you kids doing that these days. So work your tones, work your volume like the old guys, and turn it up just a touch, and you get some real nice kind of classy. I mean, that tone's just sweet.
I need a beard.
You get where I'm going with that. From there, then we start to get a lot more gain. Super crunch is my voicing. Back to 34, pump the gain up a touch. Still in the British side of things, anywhere or thereabouts. You get the idea. I need a footstool, I can't. Forgive me on that one. But you get the idea. It's a nice, classy, big gain sound. Check this out. Blackstar are always really good at this. If you back your volume off on one pickup, for example, if you've got a dual humbucker, listen to how nice it cleans up. Down to my bridge. That's pretty cool, just from moving through pickups, and that's just with one tone. When we get to OD1 and OD2, we have a really cool built-in noise gate, which you can turn off via the software package. The insider software is a really cool extension. It's free. You can download it anyway without purchasing an ID, but you can only use it with an ID amp. But it gives you a phrase trainer. You can upload and share patches and download patches as well for free around the world, as well as artist patches. And you can save all your presets in there as well. Importantly, you can save 128 presets in total. From the amp itself, you've got three banks of four, so you can access 12 from the front, but you need the foot switch, which is the FS10, which is an optional foot switch, and you can access 128 there or via the software. But when we go to OD1, if I let go of the guitar now, it's pretty much silent. So if we go for 6L6, maybe an American scooped mid, a fair amount of gain. You can kind of see where I'm going with this once I start the lick, but nice and silent. I think that one might be banned in guitar shops, but I managed to squeeze it in. But you get the impression it's a lovely, thick, American high gain. And lastly, OD2, you can really shape that how you like. Normally, I like to go for a British metal kind of vibe. So KT88s, huge valve, loads of headroom. We use it on our Series 1 200 head as well as our Gus G head sitting behind us, who plays with Ozzy. And we're going to go for a metal British tone. So ISF British, KT88s, a little less on the scooped mid, a little less on the bass, maybe boost the trebles a touch. That's really cool. So it gives you that kind of essence of something British, full of steel. So that's really the voicing and the TVP. I've kind of touched on some of that. And on from there, you've got there's three lots of effects, reverbs, delays, modulation, and there's four choices of each. There's many, many variations you can get here. It's not just one effect on at one time. You can have all three on, so one reverb, one delay, and one modulation. But the variant in sound is great. I mean, let me show you, for example, if I go back to a clean sound, clean bright, put ISF around the middle, 6L6. If I turn my reverb off completely, so it's dry, I can go from a very, very small spring reverb. So I'm into the segment just a little bit. So we get that nice classic. Nice short spring. But check it out, I'm in the same segment, I'm increasing the segment to the top and increasing the level, and you can virtually get what you deem as a cathedral type. So I'm up to the top in the segment, a bit more level, check it out. It's not something you'd use maybe for a live environment, but certainly in recording or just jamming. But versatile, great for ambient stuff, for some volume swells. It's cool for anything like that, very versatile. And that's pretty much just scratching the surface of what all the effects can do. You've got tons of delays, tons of modulations. It's really the silk on your sound. So we'll get some chorus on there. Maybe a little less reverb so we can get through. So let's add some delay now, maybe some multi-tap, which is our fourth segment. So let's slow that down with our tap tempo. So you can mix all three together and get some really wonderful sounds. Now, everything from the voicing section at the beginning there, TVP, effects can all be saved to your presets. And as we discussed earlier, 128, and you can access 12 from the front, 128 from the foot switch. The foot switch is compatible with the whole range. It all connects with a simple guitar jack cable, which comes supplied. And every aspect of the amplifier can be accessed from the pedal, even the 15. So including your presets, your tuner, your stomp box mode, so you can turn delay, reverb, modulation off, tap tempo. It's all available via the foot switch. Yeah. Okay, so now we're going to look briefly at the range of ID amps that you can get here at Nevada. So let's look firstly at the 15. We've got the same features throughout. apart from on the 60 watt and above, so the more giggable amps, if you will. You've got a master section consisting of a resonance, presence, and a master volume, as well as a mid control. So on the 15 watt and the 30 watt, you lose the mid on the amplifier, but you actually gain it still in the insider software, so you can still adjust that frequency. So don't worry, you're not losing your mid control. We've got our ID15 and our ID30. They're really perfect for practicing at home, for students, for teachers. But the 30, in actual fact, I've used myself in a gigging environment, and it can really deliver with a drummer. A drummer, again, who knows his light and shade. So it's not too bad. You can see I've picked that up fairly easy. But speaker-wise, it's 12-inch, yeah. So it really has a warm sound, and it's as loud as its valve equivalent. If you're anyone that's going into the store to try these, please try it against another valve amp. Don't be afraid to crank this valve amp next to it, whatever it is, and crank the ID, and it will really shock you how much it sounds close to it. So ID15, ID30. Next up from there, we've got the ID60 combo. 60 watts, true valve power, 399. Next up from there, if I just move that one out of the way, we've got the ID260. This is a 2x12, so 2x60 watts. It's an absolute monster. It sounds really big, and this will suit any stage from a small local pub to a theater to a small arena, anything that's semi-pro. 60 watt, 2x60, fucker. Stereo, yeah, stereo. FX in stereo, yeah. On from that, we've got the heads. We've got a 60 watt head, which is killer. It's really light. You could turn up to your gig with just this head. It doesn't matter if there isn't a cab there. You can take your 4x12, obviously, your Blackstar 412 or a 212 for that matter. But if you want to, you can take this head to a gig, plug in the emulated line out, and just have that on stage at the side. Nice and easy. Get your wedge feeding back your tone and through the front of house, and away you go. You've got yourself a guitar amp. So the emulated out on all of them is really cool. Up from that, we've got the 100 watt head. 100 watts, true valve power, absolute monster. But it's a great range, so please come down to Nevada and try it out. It's killer.